Blake, I'm at my wit's end. I don't know what to play this week. Not this one. We lost 5-0. Not this one. Games almost took 2 hours. Not this one. We got mana screwed every time. Do you have an idea?
Yeah, I got one.
Okay.
This week we're getting ginger brutal. Greetings, goblins and geist.
I'm Jay.
And I'm Blake.
And welcome to
The Cloudpost,
where we have new Magic the Gathering Arena videos every Friday. We do ask that you like this video, and we do ask that you subscribe to The Cloudpost so more people can see it.
And The Cloudpost does not pay for advertising, so please like and share this video with your Magic friends. It really helps grow the community, and we thank you for that.
Stick around for Simic Artifacts to see if they can crack this tough cookie.
All right, here we go, playing some standard artifacts because they're good in standard.
We just talked about it. If you watched our last video, we played them last round, and we wanted to make it, and here we are.
Yeah, I love how cool this like weird little like tech is. It's such a neat like it's a neat standard we live in right now.
Yeah, I mean, tough cookie's cool.
That's look at that thing. What even is that?
It's got a lot going on. We actually don't have any new cards in this hand, but this looks like a decent hand, or does it?
Dude, I hate not having Disruption Protocol up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't... Oh, dude, I think this is... I don't think this is a good hand. I can't... I don't think it is.
Yeah.
I think we mulligan it.
Okay. Seems a little better.
It's a little better. It is a
we
little
can put
awkward.
A protocol back.
Yeah, we put a protocol back. This is better.
Okay.
Just because we have Wyrmlet and we have Cookie to activate Wyrmlet.
Yeah, like we have turn two Cookie.
Hopefully we get a land that works well.
Yeah. A land would be, like an untapped green source would be really good.
That's really what the hope is. Hey, yo.
Hey,
when you
winning.
Ask for it, sometimes you get it.
Asking, thou shalt receive.
The Wyrmlet.
But, hand is cool now.
And we've used the Wyrmlet before. The Wyrmlet pops off. Mm-hmm. And I love playing against, unfortunately they're not playing it, but RDW against the Wyrmlet has a tough time to deal with it.
But mono black aggro might be a good test for it, right?
I think so. The Vine Stalk comes in tap, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
So we'll have to sequence that later. I'm assuming we want to go untap land.
We certainly do.
And then we want to just go tough cookie, right?
Yeah, let's cookie it up. And then do you think we swing the Wyrmlet here? I want to think that we do. Like, he's not going to trade that.
Okay. I mean, he could. It comes back, but also we want to be attacking him.
Yeah, I think we're like aggro, so...
Yeah.
I'm going to say we do it. Do it. Yeah, all right.
All right.
Like, I'm good with that.
So that's now. A removal spell that we just did, basically. And next turn, we're making our food token a 5/4.
That's true.
So...
Okay, well, Cookie's dead, but that's fine.
Yeah.
We get a 5/4.
Oh, Surge Engine's not a bad draw
Surge
either.
Surge Engine's pretty solid. The next turn, we can have him pop off, so.
Yeah.
We got a big boy. Let's get him.
Mm-hmm.
Roar.
5/4.
Yeah, kill our dumbass food token.
I mean, yeah, now he might feel bad as far as the edict, but he could still obviously deal with this in a number of ways.
He can't go for the throat it.
No.
He can't. He can't even cut it. He can't cut it down either, right? So the glyph pops off 3. Mm-hmm. Let's see what we get.
Just don't be another glyph, please.
That'd be bad right now. It's a protocol. That's actually kind of the worst thing to hit.
Yeah.
That literally is the worst thing to hit. Another glyph would be better than that because it could be hitting something, but that can't.
Yeah.
I guess
it goes in our hand.
So that's not so bad. Now he knows we have a counter spell.
Yeah.
But that means we have a free Surge Engine to come out.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, it doesn't because we have the tap Vine Stalk. Ah.
Yeah, we may. If we draw a different land, there you go.
Yep.
All right.
Well, he can't, yeah.
Perfect.
Yeah, we're good. We're golden here.
Yep. This is actually a fine spot to be, dude.
Yeah, we're pretty solid right here. We're feeling good. The next thing he plays gets countered. That's getting annoying. How many of those does he run?
He literally drew 3 of them at this point.
Yeah, I was like, dude, stop. Stop that. How much removal can you run? All right, let's see the Tenacious Guy. Oh, no. Really?
Ooh, okay. Well.
I kind of feel like we just got punished. Maybe. Obviously, we lose the... Nothing? Okay.
No, it has to be a creature, a planeswalker.
I thought it could
be
any non-land.
But he's going to get to search, and then he gets to reanimate.
Yeah, but what does he have to reanimate?
Well, right now, nothing. Tenacious. Yeah.
We go... Oh, wait, we can pump him.
Yeah, we can...
Do it.
Well...
You do it, dude.
Even though we don't have
this...
He has
one card in his hand. Oh, he searches
But he
for
searches.
A card. Yeah, we can't do it.
We can do it next turn.
We can't do it. We can swing.
Because of the Vine Stalk.
Get in there with Brute. Unfortunately, he knows.
And then if we don't use our counter spell at the end step, we can do Surge Engine.
Yeah, we're still good to go. Yeah. It's just we didn't get the damage immediately. Mm-hmm. I like him taking 3 damage, though.
I mean, eventually we're going to draw cards.
Yeah, we knew that was coming, so.
I mean,
does he not know?
It doesn't matter.
No, it definitely matters.
No, I just meant, like, the... I mean, he gets to reanimate it next turn.
I suppose that's good. But like, we don't have to deal with it for this turn, and we have that now.
Mm.
That's golden. Not the golden Argosy, but it's golden.
Mm-hmm. So, and then we do this.
Get in there.
And we get in there.
Okay, we have some damage.
Yep. Alright, so he gets to...
He gets to get make altered. A sack of thing.
And we're gonna sack, I guess, Brute?
Yeah, dude.
He gets a 4/5. Although Brute becomes unblockable, but this can draw cards and then it can trade with that. So I think it has to be Ginger Brute, right?
Yeah, dude. Brute doesn't save us here. Like, 7-turn clock is...
Yeah.
Okay, now we die. Now we die. But we still have the Beanstalk.
Mm-hmm.
So, that was pretty good holding the Lily there. Suspicious is going on. Dude, all he does is make us sacrifice things all day long.
Yeah. Alright, not the best draw. Also, we don't have the mana for this.
That just feels bad.
I mean, I guess we could...
Maybe we just play the schooner and that's all we can do, right?
Play it.
We can't even animate the Vine Stalk to tap it.
No. Yeah, because I was thinking, but we have to attack to get the Explorer, so...
Yeah, we just can't even... I mean, there's nothing we can do there. He had no plays. Oh, this dude, his draws are insane.
Yeah, I mean, he did have the cruelty. The cruelty was...
Yeah, but getting the Cauldron of the Apocalypse and the Liliana, like, come on, man.
It's a lot. All right, well, now we can Vine Stalk.
It's like...
Do we attack his Lily?
Read the Vine Stalk. Does it animate an artifact? Target creature. So, no, yeah, we have to attack the Lily, dude.
I mean, he can't make a sack.
I guess we could attack
on his turn.
We could swing him in the face because he can't deal with this.
Yeah, he has to trade, basically.
Yeah, it's going to have to kill the other children, so if not, he's going to deal with a lot of... Oh, we can make it a 3/3, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Takes more damage this way.
That's true.
Takes 2 more damage.
Yeah, actually, that actually matters. That literally matters.
Yeah.
Because if we have another Vine Stalk, we get in for 5, you know?
Yep. All right, so he goes to 2.
All right. Well, he goes to 4.
Or 4, rather.
But he has something he has to deal with.
Yeah. I mean, he sees it now. So, right. Yeah, he can blitz that.
He's going to go back
to 4. He's going to plus his Lily.
Yep. He'll go back to 4 life, and he just lost. Why did he do that?
I'm so confused.
I am so confused. He draws a card, but, like, he's just banking on the card, like... Did he just lose on purpose?
Well, if he draws a removal spell, I guess.
Dude, we play the glyph and animate a dude and swing it for 5.
Oh, man. Either that or the Vine Stalk, right? Vine Stalk kills him, too.
Vine Stalk kills him. I mean, I don't understand. He has to have some, my brain, dude. Just play the
glyph.
Glyph gives us the discover, just in case. We might get a blocker out of it.
Okay. Well, we're dead either way if we don't win this turn.
Yeah.
We're super dead.
We're super dead. So, glyph it up, dude.
Okay.
Like we,
this is so sketchy. All right.
I think this
fingers
is safer
crossed, everybody.
If he has a go for the throat. I mean, he just didn't have it. That's why I was like,
what?
If he's got go for the throat, I don't know.
What
man.
Did he just miscount then? Like with
have.
The Cauldron damage?
He must have. I don't. I.
All right, everybody. We got lucky.
I don't
on
know
that
what
one.
Is.
We got lucky.
That's
that does not feel right.
I'm kind of at a loss right now. I don't know what just happened in his brain, but. Maybe he just misclicked.
Well, yeah, maybe.
You got to get him while you can, so.
Yeah.
Counts as a win.
Because his draw was nutty at the end there.
Dude, it was absolutely
for
bonkers.
One, he did have 3 Cauldron's Edict, and then he had every Cauldron you could ever want.
Dude, it's like, what? And the Lily.
Oh, this hand looks sweet. This hand looks sweet.
Let's keep it then.
I mean, I just think this will be super strong.
Oh, it works really well with the Wormlet too, man.
Yeah, but like, dude, this is a 3-mana 3/4.
Yeah, plus
like,
it gets
plus
like,
the
tokens.
Map.
Yeah.
I think this is just a
the
beater.
Curve is just good here. We got Wormlet
the
right off the bat. Then we got the Brute and the Sentinel. Mm-hmm. Like, that's going to start popping off.
Yeah.
It'd be really cool if we drew a Siren next turn.
Yes.
Because then we can be like, Brute, Siren. Ah, but that's also really good. I think we play that.
We play that.
Yeah, I think we
that's
play
actually
that.
Even preferred, and we get to attack into the escort.
Let's get him.
Doo, 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 doo.
That's weird that he's running escort. I don't know how to see that card.
This must be like some kind of combo deck.
Oh, it's plus one counters.
Yeah.
All right, so it's Selesnya.
Mm-hmm. Enters with two counters on it. Whenever one or more counters are put onto another permanent, if it's the first time,
it just gives it additional.
It's an additional one.
Yeah. A little hardened scales trick.
Okay. Okay, okay.
You can play the island.
Here we go, island and sentinel.
Yeah. We get a thing. Formula gets big.
Mm-hmm.
Tap the sentinel for the schooner.
Yep.
Go ham. Let's go.
Let's go. You gotta love subterranean schooner, man. I mean, we had him with pirates.
It's like my favorite new boat.
Oh, it's so good. Now this is a five. This is a 4 or 5 vigilance, depending on what this is.
We don't really want that, do we?
We don't want that because we have enough mana, I think, to do both.
Yeah. I mean, what we want now is like a. What do we want?
Glyph to make this
glyph would be
a 5/4.
Glyph would be huge. All right, so he's doing blocks. All right, that doesn't really feel too bad. I'm cool with that. He gave lifelink, so. He didn't go anywhere, but...
And indestructible.
Yeah. But he had a sack it.
Okay,
well, there
okay
goes
that's a good card. Yeah, that's
not bad.
That's
not
good.
Bad. We have another one.
We have another one, yeah.
Yeah. It's unfortunate.
Oh, actually.
We got tech plays now, bro.
Yeah, we need to make our land drop. I think we go this and brute.
Yeah, we do.
So this, because the current conductor is about to do crazy things with having Schooner out. And we can just do this map token if you want.
We can.
Because this will
up the,
start popping off. Now,
put it on the brute.
Yeah, put it on the brute, because then, depending on what we get, the conductor does.
I don't think we want that.
It's not, I guess
it's
not.
It's not bad, but it's just, we don't have a lot of blue to sink into it, but...
yeah.
Maybe we should have kept it, I don't know.
And then, now we crew.
Yeah. Tap
this
for it, and it gets crazy. We get, that's a crazy turn. This,
mm-hmm.
this deck has so many, like... Early game insanity.
Another
dude.
Schooner. I don't know. I mean, it's not a land.
It's not, but like, part of me wants it. Is that bad?
I guess not.
It's
let's
like,
keep it.
It's, I don't know. That is.
Yeah, and this got extra value.
Yeah. I kind of feel bad
it's
for
a
the
five,
guy.
5/6, man.
The opponent wants to play with the +1/+1 counters, but these are just better. Like, this is
we're,
just better.
We're doing his thing better than him.
Yeah.
He's doing it. This is a turn, though.
Hey, man, that's Simic.
That's a turn.
Simic
right here.
Is math creatures. Like, let's talk about it, you know?
So I don't think we play this turn because we have this.
Yeah, I think that's a better play, too.
Okay.
Plus, we can make the Ginger Brood unblockable.
Mm-hmm.
And activate.
Oh, my gosh,
we can map,
dude.
Crack the map for the Ginger Brood again. Oh, wait, no, we need him.
We
want to
make him
unblockable,
but...
We have to tap into that.
But, yeah, we'll go crew here.
Yep. This seems real good.
And,
go ahead and do it.
Yeah.
And that's the end of that.
And attack out. And that's a lot of damage.
That's a lot of... Hey,
that's probably
like,
good,
yeah, that's
right?
Good,
that guy's always good.
We keep the sign. That guy got big quick.
Yeah.
I didn't expect him to be that powerful.
The dude, current conductor.
Never doubt the fish.
Man.
Never doubt the fish.
6/7 2 mana play right there. And we only had to sink like 2 turns into it.
It's weird that there's a bunch of fish that work with the explore stuff, but I mean
that does actually go back to the first Exelon set.
Okay, see, I never played that set.
Yeah,
but when I think about the lore of it, because I have looked into that, like the merfolk aren't exploring, are they? Like they're not.
They kind of are.
I thought they were chilling. Yeah, I guess they do go to the new land or whatever. So,
but yeah, there's like that's where we got a lot of the green merfolk that were
that's a win.
Exploring, you know. But yeah, I mean, what a draw that was.
That was
I don't know.
Dude.
I mean, it's not so
we get to dig though. So like, is it a draw? Does that count as a draw? You know, we're
well,
digging.
Well, I just meant though.
Time.
Well, yeah, but I guess like we just saw like a really good combination of the spells.
Oh no,
like,
it was beautiful.
Like not that we didn't help it by crafting it, but yeah. I'm saying yeah, like that combination of like having because we had Wormlet on turn one.
Yeah,
we drew Schooner,
yep.
Which is like the perfect draw because
yep.
That was our turn two play.
We even
I mean,
got the
it was just all gas from there.
It was perfect. Lands we wanted when we wanted them. The creatures when we got them. They just came out perfect timing, great tempo. And
yeah.
Then turn three is just incredible with this deck. It's really cool to see it happen. And honestly, I always bring this up, but it reminds me of Affinity a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Way slower standard status.
Yeah.
But like the value of these creatures is ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. And Subterranean Schooner is ridiculous. This hand.
This hand is ridiculous.
This hand is fine because Siren's good.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Dude, the cookie's gonna pop off. If he lives, everything is huge.
Yeah.
Now let's do it.
Yeah, because we can just make map tokens into 4/4s. We can make ginger root.
Yeah.
You know? Also shouts to our opponent's name. They're on humans, I'm scared now. Runs with sloths. Get ourselves a siren going here.
Siren. I love this card.
Yeah.
Like, what a powerful 1/1.
It's, when we played it with pirates, we just figured out pretty quickly that, hey, this card is just pretty dang good.
Yep.
All right, so...
I think
unfortunately, they have cavernous souls.
Yeah.
So our disruption protocols are less.
I think we send it. So let's run the ginger root and the siren.
Siren. Yeah.
I think we do both of these.
Okay.
Like, let's build a board.
Yeah.
Because he's obviously trying to keep things alive there.
Not that our opponent's going to be playing Cavern of Souls on humans and depopulating us. I would doubt it.
It's people have done weird stuff.
Look at these. Yeah, those are pretty lands.
Those are dead animals.
But it's the Jurassic World land.
I know they're sick. I just had to make it weird. They're all like
they eaten. Are. That is sad.
They're so sad. I do like the Jurassic World movies though. Oh, cool! We got a vampire here.
Yeah.
That's not the human I was expecting.
No.
All right, play the coast, man.
Oh man, and we drew a sentinel.
I think we play the sentinel. Part of me wants to just play tough cookie. We can just straight up.
Dang, I can't believe we could have countered this.
I
just was not expecting that.
Yeah, I mean, how would we have known?
Yeah.
You know what the fuck?
What is our line here?
You swing, bro.
And trade with the bat.
It's a bat.
And trade with a siren.
He's not gonna. I don't think he's gonna block. He might. We have so many creatures right now. It's fine. Like, we can just replace whatever we lose, and it's more powerful. And then we also have explore tokens.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, our map token. Should we map token?
I mean, we can, but then we can't play our creatures. I guess we play tough cookie. I think he plays just swing and then see what happens. We go off that.
Well, because we can't activate these as instants.
No, I know.
Okay.
I mean, I guess you could put one of them on Ginger Brute because he's probably the best thing to put that on.
Okay.
Let's make him an actual threat.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of good.
We have not...
He's not playing Graveyard Hate. We could toss it.
I don't know. I'm kind of into
it. It's really good with Tough Cookie.
Yeah, I'm into that.
So now I think we keep that on top and play Tough Cookie after we swing.
Yeah. All right.
Well, if he blocks it, cool.
He'll trade. He definitely... he doesn't even care?
No, I didn't think he's gonna.
I'm surprised. Why wouldn't you just kill our... Now, we could keep Disruption Protocol up.
That seems cool, too. All right. That seems pretty good.
All right.
Hopefully we get that, then we can, you know, get both the cards next turn.
Yeah, let's see. If he plays, like, a four-mana human, it's going to feel terrible.
It's going to be real shitty. Play another... Damn. Yep.
All right.
Well, it happens.
It happens.
Yep. You want to sack it? Is it more effective to
sack it? We have to tap it.
Oh, yeah, sorry, yeah. I don't realize that.
Yeah.
That's right, all the food's...
That's fine, I mean, we could, in theory, get it back still.
Yeah. We got Gat.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, that was me wanting to play that, I guess. So, you know, this
we go
turn...
Cauldron Cookie?
We could go Cauldron Cookie or Cauldron Protocol again, but... I don't know. This just threw me off. Like, is he playing?
No, he's just going aggro, dude.
You know,
he's an aggro.
So he's not even necessarily humans.
I think he is mostly humans. I think the Sanguine Evangelist is just a.
It's just so good.
Yeah, I mean, unless he's just playing absolute jank, which is never assumed in plat. So, we could. I think we just throw down the tough cookie.
Mm-hmm.
And then, swing. We're winning the race still.
Yeah.
Technically,
and we have food.
We have food, so.
Yeah,
I
like this.
This will just feel bad if we can't counter the next thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because then, like, why would we not play the Cauldron?
Right.
Come on, let's see what he gets.
If we do draw a land next turn, we do get Sentinel plus Cauldron.
That's true.
Yes.
Okay,
scatterable.
We get a counter target. Thank goodness. And, auto pay, we do have to take a damage to do this.
Yeah.
Tap or
that's
map
fine,
token.
Though. So much value. First off, gotta say, I love the art for Disruption Protocol, too.
Oh,
very,
definitely.
Very cool counter spell.
Definitely.
Like a foil one? Oof.
Hey, that's actually... Yeah, I was just thinking about this
good.
Card, actually.
That's real good.
Is that our best play this turn? Or is the Sentinel? Then it was a 3-4.
I think the glyph is.
Okay.
Because if he has removal, the glyph just on, replace it.
Glyph on the map token?
I think glyph on the food token.
Okay.
Well, why the map?
Because this can actually gain us life if it's a race.
That's true. Yeah, you're right. You're right. Let's do glyph on map.
Okay. 5-4. And flyers.
And flyers.
Bam. Cool with that?
Yeah, man.
Okay. I mean, because tough cookie... We could swing good. Cookie, though, because we have the cauldron to recur its ability.
That's true. Do it. We go fast.
Yeah. Make it make some decisions. Okay.
We are going to win this
race. A
race
is fine.
We are certainly winning this race.
What is... I mean, he must have a big play this turn.
He must have some balls.
Yeah.
Like...
I mean, those are good. Yeah. He gets to eat the now, but this triggers, right? Yep. Yeah. Please be something
this
decent.
Is tough cookie.
That's fine. Yeah, that's good.
Dude, that's so good.
Yeah.
We eat for days.
Yes.
It's food forever.
No one goes hungry here. Yeah, that's a good play. Yeah. That's a strong play by him.
Well, certainly. Ooh, schooner.
Okay, so we could go schooner cauldron. We could go.
Oh man. We should play the sentinel.
Uh-huh.
Make a map token, put a map token on the siren, and then force him to have to block one. Because he'll die to flyers.
Yeah. Yeah, just straight up die to him.
Let's do it.
Yeah, this is fine. And then we have a 3-4. You know, which is not nothing.
Hopefully we get a land here.
Yeah, that would be fine. But if we get the land, it's not a counter.
No,
that's
it's
okay.
Just, I just wanted to have something.
So...
Unfortunately, we didn't get counters, though, but I think we still swing at both.
And trade for his bat.
Question is, do we swing at all of them? I don't think we do, right?
Well, we would just be running one tough cookie into Adelin.
One cookie goes to the graveyard for sure, but then he also, like, does he block? He has to. He has to block then. So he loses the creature.
Okay.
And then, so he either has to lose the Sanguine so he doesn't have the battle cry anymore, or he has to give us a creature back. I guess he could use the new Brutal. He'll probably block with the new Brutal because it doesn't do anything for him. But is that valuable for us? Because the Adelin goes down then.
Yeah, the Adelin goes down. Hmm.
I think that's the play. We keep the pressure.
Well, we don't have... Yeah, this way we don't have blockers ourselves other than our 3-4.
We won't need him. He'll have to hold creatures up to keep us from killing him.
Yeah. Okay, so he goes to 2.
Yep. He does get another bat. I did
forget
about that trigger.
Yeah, that card is so good.
Yeah. No more Cathars, please.
So we take the Adelin this turn, right?
4, yeah.
And block his token.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
But here's the thing. We're going to play Cauldron next turn.
Yep.
And we already make our Siren bigger than the bat. But those flip. So then... Oh, man. You know what's sketchy about that? We should not double spell this turn.
Okay.
Because they'll flip again.
Yep. But he can make it... He can't make it happen unless he draws another spell.
Right. Right. All right. So we can Cauldron now.
Yep.
So we
can... Obviously, we put it on our Siren.
Yep.
Let's see what we get.
We could give our things Battle Cry... Which is hilarious, but we don't need it.
I think it's only activated, right?
Oh.
Read it again. I'm pretty sure it's only activated abilities. Activated abilities of creatures you can
play. Okay. But yeah, it's in the deck, so we can do stuff like this.
Yeah, we get that. Tap that spyglass, tap it up. Yeah, there we go.
Yep. Ooh, it's a 2-2.
And we have 6. We can gain life.
Yeah, we can gain life.
I feel safe
with
that.
But we attack just with our Siren.
Yeah. Oh, we could do that.
What?
Animate a food.
Yeah.
He has to block it. One of his creatures dies. And then he has to... So two creatures will die.
Okay. Are we not dead if we do it? I guess we're not dead if we do it, right?
Yeah.
And we don't attack with our Sentinel, I don't think. It's tough,
no,
man, because he can just eat it with Adelin.
We swing these two.
Yeah. We go all attack, keep this back. I mean, I would love to swing Sentinel, but...
So now he's got to block the flyer, and he loses one of the... Brutes or Adelin, which is fine.
Yeah, that would be great.
He's like, oh, I got.
He should chump with the one brute that's
He doesn't want to give us a cookie back.
Yeah, you know what's sick too. Next turn we can Soul Cauldron the other tough cookie onto the Nameless City if we get to that point.
Why didn't he double block?
Oh wow,
that was a bad
we gave
point.
Him that.
Yeah,
we gave him that. I didn't see it.
No, it was fine. He could have double blocked.
But he first strike would have killed it. He would have even lost the thing.
He just scooped.
Yeah.
Dude, what is going on today?
man. Well, hey. That's why you guys subscribe to the Cloud Post. Sometimes yeah. we run hot, but
oh wait, that was
but he had charge. He had double block. He probably scooped also because he may have even saw it, and we didn't see it.
Dude, that was well. It's a fun day.
All he had to do was double block with both his both brutes and their first strike.
I was like, wait a second, why didn't he just?
And then we probably lose.
Yeah, I think we would have lost.
Yeah. It would have been close.
We've gotten away with murder, man. Absolutely.
Man. Murder. Well, this deck is sweet, though.
It is a cool
deck. The deck is really cool.
I think we could be playing it better.
Yeah.
My bad. Oh, man.
This hand's closed.
Every
but...
fiber of my being wants to keep this hand.
We know how strong this can be.
Can
in
we
chain.
Keep it? Can we keep it?
It's close, dude.
Dude,
we need one. We need a third land.
Let's keep it.
Here's the big question, too. Do we go turn one?
Vinestalk.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a little slower, but it, dude, if this happens,
yeah.
it's nuts.
Man, this is a risky keep.
It is a risky
keep. We normally try to be disciplined. All right,
at least we have something we can play.
But I think we still go turn two Tough Cookie because it's the more mana efficient play, right?
Damn,
oh, wow.
Damn. Well, hold on, hold up. Yeah, I know you're right. Cookie's best. Come on. Come on, game.
Because then if we do draw the third land, then we... Lift the food.
Yep. It's definitely the right play.
Oh man, we can only hope at this point.
Okay. Alright, he's playing tokens.
Mm-hmm.
Boy.
Black white tokens. Classic archetype.
I love this.
Truly
archetype.
Is. So if you're still watching and still with us at this point in the video, please tell us what you think.
We don't block that, do
we? I don't think so.
I don't think we do.
Unless you want to.
No. No blocks. We take the knight. All right.
But yeah, give us a like on the video. Give us a comment.
This might be a hard matchup for us.
Mm-hmm. And that made it harder, unfortunately.
I think we just double down on cookies, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Swing in, I guess. Oh, it's got vigilance, dude. That feels so bad. We don't swing. We can't.
We can. See if he blocks it. We have another tough cookie now.
I guess, yeah.
I mean, we could have blocked him at this point, but I mean, it's you know.
Yeah, right. Didn't know this is my fault for picking the hand we.
I mean,
chose.
Well,
land changes the world, though.
Yeah, because then we're gonna start
like a glyph every turn.
Discovering
is quite powerful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a glyph on a ginger brute is so good.
Yeah, because you can make the haste thing.
Yeah. Anti, basically unblockable. And it's like,
unblockable 5/4.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
So hopefully he misses a land drop.
Yeah.
Hopefully they miss a land drop, and then we still got a game. Because we have a handful of cards. He's got a handful of cards.
And we just
he hasn't played
other.
A land yet.
No, he hasn't. So,
so
it's
do
good.
We block this time?
Part of me doesn't want to, but I think...
Part of me wants to.
I think we should.
We have
because
a lot of gas,
guy, he,
and then
he
want to
draw
we don't
card,
want it to be
weird.
Big.
It's weird that he didn't want to draw a card.
Mm-hmm. Man, because when he gets to 5 mana, too, he's going to have virtue, so there is pressure on us.
Ganjo,
and that's
land.
Annoying, because that's
that gets,
a land.
Yeah.
All right, we really need a land.
Yes, we do.
We really need a land
Come
this
on.
Turn to be in this game.
Yu-Gi-Oh, help us. I don't know.
Part of the cards.
Damn,
oh.
There's no heart there.
That's like about as bad of a draw.
That's probably the
that's
worst
possible.
Thing we could get. Play the Wormlet and call it a day.
Well, we did this to ourselves.
We did. Do we swing?
Maybe it trades for two tokens.
That feels bad. Don't swing.
Because they're going to become 2/2s.
Oh, they're
going
to be so big. We have to swing. Damn it, dude.
Like, if he trades right
have
here,
to have some
it's actually okay.
Here. All right, yeah. Oh, boy. I did this, and I knew better. I just liked having three glyphs in our hand, and of course, instant punished. Instant punish,
I tell you, you know, we are huge Magic fans. We watch Magic content. You will see
I like
people
having fun sometimes.
Who are very good at this game. They keep aggressive hands sometimes.
Ugh, this is
shouts to Andre Mengucci. I just watched a video he made the other day. He's like, man, I don't like to mulligan. He's like, you got to get lucky. It's Magic. And I'm like, that's true. But...
Oh, dude, I'm like polar opposite.
I know.
I feel
I know.
Like I just mulligan like a monster half the time.
Yeah. Yeah, and normally,
I feel like
getting a more functional hand, yeah, you get rewarded.
Normally, I don't ever do this kind of thing, but I was like, this is hilarious. Let's try it. And the fact that we haven't been able to do it is crushing my heart. Like, it's so depressing. I really
want
to.
We could dream. We could have dreamed, right?
Yeah, no, I mean, it's...
And he's going to pop off
The dream
now.
Is still possible, you know, he's got...
he's going to pop off now, though. The loyalty, this is going to be real hard to win. Because, yeah, he's got Virtue, which is even bad. He's debating playing the Virtue because of how good his hand is, I guess.
Maybe he... Yep. What in the fuck?
I haven't seen the Betrayer's Sting in a while.
I'm just confused Betrayal's by why sting. This, though. Sure. Proliferate to pump the counters in the announcement.
And also flip the Aganjo.
I guess you can always get all the counters in your dudes from the Virtue, so it's not bad. It's no, just a weird choice. Because it doesn't make tokens, I guess, is a weird choice. Like, it doesn't really progress the deck.
Right.
It's really just a win more card.
Yeah. I mean, I guess the neg 2 is never bad.
It's like a weird 6 mana removal spell. Like,
just take it.
Yeah, we don't block that. Yes! Right. Oh, there's hope yet.
It was late, dude, but here it is.
We pop that thing on one of those foods and we smack him.
Now, we gotta attack Betrayer, though, don't we?
Oh, yeah, dude.
Yeah.
We swing all three at Betrayer. Actually, not the Tough Cookie, sorry.
Okay.
Because the other one's gonna get Death Touch.
Yeah.
So.
Or do we swing the Death Touch at him?
That doesn't do anything.
Okay. Alright. Yes. We get to discover.
Yes, value. We killed it with a freaking food.
Mm-hmm.
I did forget about that.
Yeah, he's gonna get that. He gets it when he attacks, too, so it was gonna be inevitable.
Hey, Gingerbread's
fine.
Hey, it gets bigger.
Yeah.
We gain a life. The value.
Oh, man. We might be able to stay in this game if we hit a land and just flip up the Gingerbread.
Dude, it's huge right now. Well, he's gonna Vraska the Gingerbread. If he doesn't, he's a fool.
Yeah. And then it'd be sick if we drew Agatha Soul Cauldron. Oh, just start making other things
if
Gingerbroots.
If everything's a Gingerbroot, that's going to be an issue. Mm-hmm. That's going to make some big, big problems for him.
But, I mean, I don't know, man. It's a race because he's going to have crazy cards.
Dude,
yeah, that can exile our Wyrmlet.
What is happening?
Dude, his hand is gas.
His hand
we
is,
know his hand is
I
gas.
I thought it was like tokens, but it's like Super Friends. I was wrong.
Mm. It's kind of both, though.
It's definitely more Super Friends based. Seeing the Vraska, that explains it now.
Yeah, because he gets to proliferate.
Yep, it all's coming together.
Put an extra counter on here.
I really would like a land.
There you go.
Please
you
give
it.
Us a land. One
yeah,
land,
we do
please.
Need a land.
One land, please. Please,
man,
God, let it be a land.
You know, if we had more tempo, like appropriate tempo this game, like Disruption Protocol would have been amazing against this deck. He's just tapping out for 4 and 5 mana plays, you know?
Yep. Like that. He's tapped out. Got a bunch of tokens. We don't block. Get hurt. We are hurt now.
He also gained a life.
Yes.
All right.
Did
that.
We don't even need to freaking... dude, I'm torn now. I don't even know what to do. We glyph for sure.
Okay.
But do we glyph our brute? I think we glyph our brute.
Okay.
Or do we... No, we glyph the food. We glyph the food because he's going to blow it up.
He's going to exile.
He's going to kill whatever thing we
well,
do.
Well, we can... Oh. Well,
so we have
let's
to glyph
see
the,
for a second.
We glyph
let's
the
see.
Food, we swing the food at Vraska, and the one at the Wandering Emperor.
Yep, yep, yep.
And he feels dumb for it, but it's what happens.
So this notches that down. This kills this.
Yay, we got there. All right. Well, we're nearly dead.
Yeah, yeah. That's the other thing.
But I feel like that was the right play.
Yep, we just, I mean... We just shouldn't have kept this hand, that's all.
No, it's true. My lesson was learned.
But I was into it.
If we somehow come out of it, I'll feel like a champion.
Oh my god. I don't know if that's possible.
He's going to have to kill the thing with the glyph on it, and then we get to glyph again, man.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, our best draw would literally be, like, Agatha Soul Cauldron into land.
Yeah. Good, come on. Can you not have more planes?
Disruption Protocol.
You can't.
It let me put it on the stack for some reason.
Did you think it would?
Oh, it's
no,
hexproof.
Dude, not a lot. I think it just died, right? Is that 3? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
2, 4, 6.
That's 8.
9.
I'm bad at math right now. I just can't. It's been a long
time. Oh, wait.
Is it 10?
10. But that's it.
I said 10, so we're going to 1. You can get us to 1, buddy. Go on.
Such a weird planeswalker. You've brewed with it in the past. In fact,
she's good. It's
one of the
like
first
so
videos
expensive.
For the Cloudpost was an Orzhov Doom for Told deck that you ran this in. I think, right?
No, it was a different Kaya. Different Kaya, but yes.
Oh, it was a different Kaya?
This one's too new.
Oh, right. This is all will be one.
Yeah.
But there was cool. There was another big mana Kaya, right? It was like a big mana one, right?
Five mana? Yeah. That was with Kaldheim.
Okay.
Cool card. So we're very hurt.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, also there's that.
At least we got to keep our food.
Mm-hmm.
Also, I don't know what, you know, I don't know what's going on in his brain. But in my brain, I see that we have another glyph and a food token. And he has two dead planeswalkers. But we will probably die. No, we won't die. We won't even die from that. That's actually the right play. Throw it on the food again. You do the same thing.
Okay. Because
that's all we do. That's all we're capable of.
So what do we swing
it
at?
Why did it... Oh my god, the lands, dude. We had a protocol up.
No!
It didn't let us have it. That might have cost us the game, the stupid tapper. All right, well, we have to... We want... Tap the One Ring Emperor and kill Kaya. Oh, we can't.
Mm-mm. They can block.
Yeah, Kaya kills us no matter what then, right? So...
I mean, we can swing. We can swing at Kaya. He has to double block our glyph.
So the brute goes to the Emperor.
Yeah.
So you might as well make it unblockable, unfortunately. Okay. Oh, hold up. No, he's tapped out. Sorry. Overthinking it.
Yeah, having our counterspell up would have been good. But also, this is not even... the worst situation we could be in.
Ta-da.
Because we're probably going to discover right here. Unless he just chumps.
Oh, we're dead. No, we're not dead. Yeah, we're dead. We're dead. Sorry, I did the math wrong. Oh, no, he did double chump. We're not dead. He could have killed us.
Yeah, we go to one.
Because what he could have done, what did we get? Hey!
A boat.
That's cool.
That's fine.
Neat. What he could have done, he could have blocked with just one of those tokens.
Yeah, and then we would be dead.
Then we'd be dead because he'd
give it a plus got plus three one damage counter. From Kaya, the plus one counter, plus five.
And the fortress. We might just be dead anyways.
Oh, yeah. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah,
we're dead.
If he sees
it. If he sees it, which I assume he sees it. There's a plus one. Yep, that happens.
The good old concede here in a moment.
Yeah, let's see if he gets it. No, it would be very funny.
He does have to see it.
All of our other players have fucked up.
It's true. There's that. That's one.
The chance, man.
Now, we go to one unless you just animate your thing. We have one colorless mana.
He's thinking about playing another card. What is it going to be?
He just, like, taps out for this, which is, like, it's a great card, but it doesn't win in the game this turn.
No.
But also, you know... we can't beat him next turn either.
I don't think
so.
What
okay, gets
is...
an Aklazotz. You had the game.
Yep.
Okay.
No, we don't concede.
Okay.
We give the people a show.
Yeah.
I want to make him feel bad for his plays, man. He can swing four at us. Yes, that happens.
First strike.
Yeah, there's no blocking that. We go to one. You got a trick. You
had. Bam.
He had the game, dude. This is why people lose.
Yeah. All right.
So now we got to win. That's all we got to do.
Man. All right. Let's do the math. We need to do 19 damage. We
can't beat him, dude. The flyer kills us.
Mm-hmm.
That's really the end of it. Well, we can explore. We're going to have to explore. So play the Sentinel.
Okay.
All right.
We'll get tapped correctly this time.
Yeah. Surprise. You did one thing right, game. I don't think it mattered too much. We could have countered Aklazotz, which actually could have helped a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that feels funny. Oh, wait, what are you doing?
You said you wanted to explore.
With the schooner, sorry, the schooner building.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So what's our play?
You put the...
Because we can make this, we don't even have to crew with it. We can make it a 5-4.
No, we crew with it.
Okay.
We're dead anyways, we just crew with it.
Well, we can also put this on the map and then crew this and attack a bunch of idiots.
It's just the flyer kills us. We have to find a removal spell. We don't have one, though, in the deck, I don't think.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, we're all right. We concede.
Okay.
I thought we had some kind of removal, but I don't think we have one.
Nope. We are much more on, if it's
train.
A race, we're under the food plan.
Yeah.
And that's
about
it. I
will call this my fault. This game is my fault.
I can take equal blame. Tell us in the comments.
No.
Whose fault is it?
It's my fault. I wanted to keep a dumb hand, and I am such an advocate for good mulligans.
I agree. Learning how to mulligan with a deck is like next level of the deck.
The temptation of fun, though.
Temptation
three
of
ritual,
fun.
Three zoetic
Here's
rituals,
the thing.
Dude.
It's not even just the temptation of fun. It's the temptation of how much would we have smashed if all we did was draw a land on turn three.
That's true.
Like, we would have probably just won the game.
Yeah. This is a great hand.
It only has two lands.
Yeah, we have everything that plays too, except for the Sentinel.
Okay.
It's a little slow, that's true. I didn't think about that part. Yeah, that comes untapped, and we suffer for it, yes. Mm-hmm.
But we can go, even if we have to do our second tap land, we can go Wurmlet this turn.
Wormy.
And tap land.
Alright.
Alright, so we are back.
I'm glad we're on the play on this one.
In the situation of needing a land drop.
Yeah, we have plays, though.
Yeah, but that was perfect. So we have a land drop. So we're doing great. So now we go, I think, Wurmlet Tough Cookie.
Yeah. Wurmlet Tough Cookie or Engine, but I think Cookie's the best play. Far. Yeah, look at those triggers.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, so many triggers. Yes.
Bam.
I didn't think about the double.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so good.
Yeah.
That is so good.
So next turn.
Sentinel.
Sentinel.
And it does the same thing.
Mm-hmm. And then we swing for 8.
Gross.
Yep. Swing for 8.
And we'll be at 26, 28. Oh, okay. He's playing Reanimator. We got to crush fast.
Well, we haven't played against this in a minute.
We also have a really good matchup because we mainboard Agathas.
Yeah.
We can exile things. Atrox,
well, wait,
you.
you're seeing
yes.
You're seeing Reanimator? I was thinking Domain. Or am I just...
No, it's both.
Okay. It's both. All right, so, well, then let's just go Soul Cauldron Brute and just get it out there, right?
We don't put the Cauldron out.
He can't. Well, so the fastest he can reanimate is what, turn 5?
Yeah.
Okay.
Unless he has
we just go Sentinel then?
Mana Dork. Yeah, I think we Sentinel it up. Let's go, Big Worms.
Yeah, because we still get triggers.
Big Worms. Is he actually a worm type?
Yeah.
Okay, I wasn't sure. He looks like a little Drake, so I wasn't
yeah.
sure if he was like a...
Let's attack go. All.
You're gonna
send
source
it.
The plowshares or Cookie, man? What's going on?
Yeah. Okay.
He's thinking. He's got a play.
Oh, he's got the binding.
We knew that. Come on. We should have known. How did I not know?
Yeah.
Dude. The value of a one mana creature.
Yeah. I mean, this was one mana, but he had to pay the tax of his things, right?
He had to pay the tax.
Mm-hmm.
And his Mauled Hound would say... I don't know. He'd probably say something crazy.
Okay. Well, that's a good card.
That's a cool card. Worm? Worm Cauldron? Or Cookie? Cookie Activation.
No, I like Worm Cauldron. Oh.
Cookie Activation. He just has to deal with one of our fat-ass creatures. We have 3 of them.
Yeah.
The Cookie is the beat train option.
It doesn't grow the Wurmlet, though. It
doesn't grow the Wurmlet. But the Wurmlet still kills that thing.
It trades.
Yeah.
I think, though, but if we made this a 4-4 and this is a 3-4 and he can't even kill any of our things...
More value?
I don't know, though, because then he gets to attack.
Play the Worm.
Okay.
Yes. Play the Worm and the Cauldron. And we'll eat... We'll have his graveyard hated now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, do it. Do the
and
cauldron.
Then we get to...
He has a creature, right? Oh, no, he doesn't. It's just the herd.
But do we get a counter no matter what or not?
Negative.
Okay. So, yeah, we just attack. We just attack with
this. Oh, we're dumb.
Why?
Wait. Never mind. I'm sorry. Keep going.
Okay.
This is
the play I envisioned.
I'm so behind today. Read the Cauldron. I'm pretty sure that you had to hit a creature.
Yeah, it says it. It says when a creature is exiled this way.
Yeah.
Put a counter. Yeah.
Yep.
But also, this does say you may spend mana... of any color to activate abilities, which is sometimes relevant in this deck.
It is good for Tough Cookie.
Ooh.
Oh, snap. That's pretty good hate.
That card is strong.
At least we have a Ginger Brute. It doesn't, like, shut down our deck. It definitely hurts us.
It hurts the Wurmlets, right?
Real bad.
Oh.
We block that, right?
I think so.
We block with a Worm and a Sentinel? He chooses to kill one of the two?
Well, he just kills Worm. That's it. He can't
even kill Sentinel.
He kills the Worm.
Seems
that's
fine.
Yeah. And then we get to exile his Flesh Gorger. It's not. It doesn't have activated abilities, but we get a counter.
We do get a counter. You go for it. Activate that. Agatha. Yeah.
Where do we put the counter?
That's what I'm thinking too.
Tough. Well, we need to be able to beat this. The 4/7.
I think you added to the Wurmlet because it's got Death Touch.
Yeah. But it already has Death Touch.
No, it only has Death Touch if we have artifacts. You have 3 artifacts, and he's got metal.
Well, yeah, but we got so much, though.
True. So
we Sentinel? Start growing the Sentinel? Yeah.
It's cool.
Oh, that can be very good. That can be very good.
I think we pop in... Oh, man. It's either Surge Engine or Brute. Surge Engine, we have to grow.
Mm-hmm.
Brute can just be Brutal right off the bat because he can't block it. I think we Brutal. I think we Brute it up.
Brute.
Root, kill the exile the wormlet from. Oh, wait. I don't know what that was about.
It's just the haste I get. Well,
he still has haste.
He still has haste.
I think it's just a weird.
Oh, thing no. It was the teething wormlet. Ah. It was teething wormlet.
So, cauldron away our wormlet, and then give Gingerbrute the
good counter.
One. Yeah. Yeah, we got the plays now. It's all coming together.
Here. And we still attack with wormlet because it's the death touch.
You're going to make him unblockable, though.
Yep. Do we explore on him, too?
I think we do.
Yeah.
Explore on him.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if we want that or not.
We can mill it. 12? We need the land.
Yeah, we could use a land.
And then we can make things ginger brutes with the cauldron.
Yeah, that's so, like we keep feeding the cauldron. That's actually smart.
So, but and we, then we go unblockable.
Yep. And we get in.
And then we get in with these.
Yeah.
Which, probably next turn, depending on his play, we just attack all.
A spicy. You know? We're at 30. Holy shit.
Yeah. Yeah. Look at the residual life gain that we got from the wormlets. All right, he has to have an epic play here. He can't go herd migration yet. He's only on 6 mana. He can herd migration next turn, but guess what? Gingerbrute beats that. This is an epic play, probably, right?
I don't think it kills us. I think he still dies.
Does he run the dumb combos?
Oh, this looks different. I don't know the invasion, man.
This one.
That's different.
I got you. Get over here. 4 damage to another target battle.
4 opponent? He does 4 to our face? And then 1 damage to the... What in the world? What in the world? This is not the combo I'm familiar with. He's dealing 1 damage to Tough Cookie. Okay, it triggers twice. So, what happened to the 4 to our... I'm so lost right now.
Oh, so he does flip. He does flip it.
Oh, he flipped the battle because it triggered twice. I see. That makes sense.
Because of Elshnorn.
Yeah. This is just a weird domain. What even is happening right now?
Oh my gosh.
Karn Silex?
Wow.
What?
All right, so we have to just try to find a way to kill him this turn.
It's not very hard.
Yeah, I think we can. He gets to copy Leyline Binding.
He messed up.
Well, no, he gets 2 triggers on it.
We actually we might be screwed. That might be the end.
Oh my gosh, he is popping off now.
What an insane... Yeah, so now he hits the next invasion. Yeah. So he gets his invasion. So much to think about.
Rip, man, that's all he had to hit. I mean, he just went to Elshnorn and to... into invasion of Alara.
Yep. The only thing we shouldn't... Oh, wait. We have any crazy plays?
I mean, we milled Gingerbrute, unfortunately. Right,
so we play the Yamaval Coast. Mm-hmm. We play the Surge Engine. Yeah, we play the Surge Engine. Oh, God, there's so much to think. All right. You put Agatha Soul Cauldron on the Surge Engine, obviously. Gonna exile away. What do we got? Do we already do Tough Cookie?
We haven't exiled away Tough Cookie.
Do Tough Cookie. Oh, wait. Oh my god.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, well, I guess do it anyways.
Or Gingerbrute?
Yeah.
It doesn't get haste, but
no,
it gets.
No, do Tough Cookie, because we want his ability for next turn. Mm-hmm. So, I just didn't think that was. Yeah, I guess play the Conductor.
Okay.
And then, you know, call it a day.
Hopefully he doesn't just kill us here, basically.
Yeah.
I mean...
Yeah, pretty much. He could Silex, but then all his stuff pops away.
He's got a lightning strike in hand. I mean...
Dude, how many of these exist?
Well, because he's popping off with them. Man. You know, we haven't actually played any of these crazy combo decks.
I'm not a fan of them, I'll be real. I think they're just kind of cheese. They're also, like, really not... Like, obviously when you get it, you get it. But, like, otherwise, I feel like you just lose to mono red over and over again before you get it.
Mm.
I think it's a hard grind, man.
Yeah. Us here, because we're about to take 13. Yeah.
Best of ones. Yeah, no, we died. That was cool. I'll give him that. Like, he had the combo. It happened. So, that's a fair end right there to a little legacy there. But I'm glad that, I didn't screw up an undefeated run.
right. Like, we would have got smashed on that.
I was like, no.
So,
but that's how that goes.
This deck is sweet. We're going to talk about it a little bit more. Stick around for the recap. Blake, tell me your favorite thing about this Simic artifact nonsense.
Favorite thing? Damn.
Yeah.
I love the Zoetic Glyph, but also Agatha's Soul Cauldron has a special place in my heart. Yes. That card is incredible, but you have to know how to power it correctly.
Yes. So we're going to talk about the choices in this deck, but once again this week, we have brought you guys a super high synergy aggro deck, and I would say, though, that the synergies in this deck are even higher than the Gruul deck.
Yeah, I think this is a definitely one of the most aggro decks in the format right now, and it has so much value. Every creature you play has just insane value.
Yes. I love the numbers in the deck. A lot of classic aggro decks are a bunch of four ofs anyway, but I love how they're kind of distributed with this one. But let's talk about some of the choices. I think the most powerful, they're all great, but I think like the most critical one drop is probably Gingerbrew. Do you disagree?
So I'm a little torn on that. I think Gingerbrew definitely matters, but I think Gingerbrew is less important than the Wurmlet when it comes to like your early game plays. And you want Wurmlet to start stacking up counters and be really powerful.
Yes. Wurmlet gets huge.
Wurmlet gets huge, and you want him to get huge. I think Gingerbrew may be the best one drop in the deck, but as far as a turn one play goes, Wurmlet is incredible.
And we saw it. It was regularly a 3/3, 4/4, 5/5.
It just grows, dude. It just grows and grows. Big old worm. I mean, so I also really do like the Spyglass Siren. You almost never want to play it on turn one if you have the Wurmlet.
Right.
It just, the value of like triggering it is so good.
Yeah, I mean, I guess your best, I mean, one of your best curves would be turn one Wurmlet, turn two Siren Gingerbrew.
You got this guy here. He's really powerful with the map token. I mean, the Wurmlet just triggers from everything.
Mm-hmm.
And you got Mr. Cream Gobbler here. He's just, you know, he's just good because he can't block him. Just unblockable,
yeah.
You know? So those are the best turn ones that I could imagine, you know?
Yeah, and so I'm a fan of everything this deck is doing, but another excuse to play Subterranean Schooner is amazing.
This card's insane.
This card's insane.
It's taking over Standard.
Yeah, I mean, look at it. It should. And we would not be able to go next if not talking about Tough Cookie.
Tough Cookie is a special breed.
It is.
It is, like, first off, the art, the creature, the activated abilities, and you know what? Let's make it a food. Let's make it make a food, you know? Like, let's just have all this value on one little uncommon. Man, when they say power creep, this thing is a bear.
Yeah.
This is a bear. This is what bears have become.
Yeah, and this is a 2-for-1 artifact spell. It's 2 instances of activated abilities to gain 3 life if you need to.
Mm-hmm.
And, let's not forget, it can turn the food token it creates into a 4-4 the very next turn.
Yep. So it itself is a food token.
Yeah, it's a game plan all to itself. So it's very strong.
Very strong.
The one of the only pieces of interaction you have with the deck is Disruption Protocol, but I think it's a very good deck for Disruption Protocol.
So I'm torn in this card. As much as I do love the card, and I love the flavor text. I just read that. Let's just turn that off, shall we? It reminds me of like a Reman flavor text. Mm. Sorry. If you don't know, Reman has a really funny flavor text, so go pull that one up. But the one time it happened, and it's not going to happen every time, Zoetic Ritual made it, or Zoetic Glyph made it, you know, hit it with Discover, and it's like, oh, it's dead. But it went to our hand, so actually, no, it's not. I take it back. It did go to our hand.
It goes to our hand. It takes dead. Away the element of surprise.
Yeah.
Also, watch your Arena Auto Tapper. You know, watch it. But either way, yeah, the deck is, or this card is powerful in the deck because it's most of the time only 2 mana because you have the artifact.
Yeah.
So I think it's high synergy. However, I will also admit, I don't know if an aggro deck like this likes holding up mana for a counterspell.
I was just about to mention the same thing, and like where I'm at with it, like I think it's just using it as a value card.
Mm-hmm.
But where I think the replacement should come in, and if you are going to change this card out, I would suggest running like maybe a bounce spell.
Yeah, like slip out the back.
Slip out the back, or honestly, that's probably the best because it gives the counters.
Yeah, it gives counters. I mean, something in that nature. Now, you could run the, I believe it's, is it Fading Hope is the still standard one where you scry?
Yeah, Fading Hope was what I was thinking of.
Yeah.
Slip out the back might be better because
you can
also use it on
yourself.
Slip
out the back, you can still target your creatures, but also their creatures.
Yeah, but it gives you value, and it gets the Agatha Soul Cauldron +1/+1 counters to matter more.
Yep.
I think that might be the better play to have as a bounce spell in this deck. And that's just, you know, my own suggestion, and I guess maybe Jake's.
Yeah.
But the protocol's not bad. But a bounce spell, I think, could have come in handy several times
right
in our 5 matches that we played.
Yeah. So. Definitely. I mean, if we were able to take like Elshnorn out of play for a turn when people are popping off.
The one turn we needed it to matter, took it out of play.
Yeah.
Also just using it to get rid of like a blocker just mm-hmm. wins the game.
Right. So yeah, think about that. We know you're going to download the deck for yourself on Aether Hub, so you may want to tweak that. We've got a couple of two ofs we're going to touch on quickly. We have Surge Engine. This card is high synergy for the deck. We never went all in on it to actually draw the cards. This probably is a flex spot, mm-hmm. but ultimately I think it is good. You can think about it as a, you know, a two mana play or a three mana 3/2. I think it's good, but it's probably a flex spot.
Yeah, I think this card is very powerful in the late game. Like something you like are okay with drawing later on because you know you can win with it the next turn. But yeah, flex spot. I don't know what you would put in for it. I think you still need creatures. So mm-hmm. if you guys do have cool creature concepts for this, let me know what it is. I was thinking maybe Patchwork Automaton, but
right. Surprised not to see this in that. But and then we have here very interesting card that we only drew once, but it was great. The current conductor, Nikinzil, if you will.
I would say that if this wasn't a legendary, you'd run four of these.
Yeah, I mean, so the deck explores a lot. You have Spyglass Siren, mm-hmm. you have Subterranean Schooner, mm-hmm. and you have Sentinel of the Nameless City. Plus, there are already other +1/+1 counter things. We're gonna, you know, talk about Soul Cauldron here for a second, but yeah, this card is just high synergy and it works very well with the deck. Agatha Soul Cauldron, Blake already said it, it might be his favorite card in the deck. This card is very powerful. It's played in Eternal formats because it is so broken, and this is a great home for it.
I can't believe they printed this card still.
Yeah.
I'm just going to say that. So, that's the end of that.
That's the end of that. And last but not least, we have a couple 3-drops we'll talk about. Sentinel of the Nameless City just seems super strong in the deck. Vigilance is good. Make an artifact. Can immediately crew your... can immediately crew your Subterranean Schooner, and it gets more map tokens when it attacks.
And of course, it triggers everything else because of that. But I gotta say, I love me a creature with a fat butt.
Oh, yeah.
They matter.
They matter. And speaking of fat in general, this is the reason the deck is kind of even thought of.
Dude, this card's so sick. It's like in Soul Artifact, but like, can't say better, but just as good in the sense.
It really is just as good. So I mean, cool. The Discover is really strong.
Like, I'm like, okay, yeah, they're gonna remove it, but I don't even feel bad about that.
Yeah.
It can replace itself. It literally can hit another one.
Mm-hmm.
That didn't happen to us, but that would have been hilarious.
And it happened against us.
It has happened against us, yeah.
So, other than that, you have a nice mana base.
The old land package. The Vinestalk is the only real curveball in this one. And honestly, you could do without it if you wanted to be a little bit more aggressive. You could, instead of that, you could run the Mitra's Factories,
mm-hmm.
and it would come in untapped. That's the only thing is... this card coming in tapped has kind of fucked us up a little bit.
Yeah, we did feel like we had a lot of draws with the tap lands. I mean, ironically, just literally that and Dreamroot Cascade. I will say, though, I mean,
it is
the one turn,
card.
The one game we got to animate it, it felt good.
It did feel good to have, so.
That's 6 mana.
Yeah.
You know, so. But there is a super secret sideboard. We did not craft this deck ourselves. We will give a shout out to Icy Fox. Who actually had the deck. I believe I'm saying that right.
Icy Wolf.
Different animal. Anyway, so download this deck for yourself. The link is in the description below, and you can see the sideboard for it. Tell us what you think. We'll see you next week.